them out of the successor to the Skellige's throne. That's another side quest then, isn't it? Okay. What was I given there? I was given something. Alright, let's go to quests. It's got to be quest about the throne. King's Gambit, will that be it? We've got to help both. Yep, that's got to be it then, isn't it? Let's find a fast travel point, because that place is miles away. Beecher.
Did you sever his head? Head of a chair.
Oh, he's there. Oh, it's down here. Wait.
Master Geralt. A guard spotted you from the tower. They sent me to open the gate.
Tower.
Why was it closed? Is that famous Skellige hospitality?
Me. 'Tis tradition. After the feast, the Jarls will choose the king, so the doors must remain closed. Only the sons and daughters of Skellige may stay in the castle.
Krach, make an exception just for me?
All know what you did for Ceres and Hjalmar. Today, you're one of us.
Excellent.
Krach awaits.
There's a massive feast and I get fed.
Too calm.
How's that?
We've an adage here at Skellige. At a good feast, mead and blood flow in equal measure. Surely you consider this barbaric on the continent?
No, not sure. Sounds preferable to dull banquets garnished with court intrigue.
Step careful there.
Uh-oh, he's fighting.
I have as much right to it as you do!
And I'd expect you to support me. Not pinch my allies. If an uncrate's to wear the crown, it
should be you, because you've got fur growing on your chin, that it?
Show some of your own, and the Jarls just might listen to you.
Put your mug smacked. Remember, I was left standing last time you crossed fists.
Oh, really?
So you'll fight the Vilkars with me. Wonder who'll do better, you or Hjalmar, the Giant Slayer?
Oh, stop your shite, Bolstein.
Ceres! Hey! Ah, damn it!
Don't see Krach. You talking to the Jarls?
No, went to his chambers. To prepare your promise. No
doubt. If you've a spell, Witcher, perhaps you'd fancy some fisticuffs with the Vilkars. Loosen up your joints after your journey.
Maybe later.
No, do it now. I want to fight some fisticuffs now.
Birna. Feast not to your liking?
This is no feast. It's a farmer's market where votes are bought and sold like sheepskins.
Svanrig is not going to vie for support.
Bran's son will not haggle for a crown that is his by right.
Far as I know, crown goes to the claimant who gains the most votes.
That is the tradition, but not all traditions are good. The Isle's care should be entrusted to a single family.
What's wrong with voting for your king?
Take a walk. Listen and you'll understand. The claimants already hand out land, promise privileges, titles, favourable judgments. They behave like whores lifting their skirts for every passerby. A king by the grace of votes is no ruler, but a debtor. This must end. We must start by placing Bran's firstborn son on the throne. I hope the Jarls will see the wisdom of it.
Leaving Caer Troldha?
Tomorrow at daybreak. Enjoy yourself, Master Geralt.
May I?
You must, even. Come! I've been waiting for you. So, feast to your liking? Any better than your continental balls?
Definitely more to drink.
Aye, there is. Rolled all of it out of my cellars. Double meads, triple, Cintrian plum brandy, a Hackamum spirit that burns the mouth like boiling water.
Oh, nice.
Clan on Crate knows the meaning of hospitality.
Something tells me there's a purpose to your hospitality.
Aye, there is. In the Isles, mead and meat stand to gain you as much support as feats accomplished blade in hand.
If that's true, you can rest easy about how the vote will turn out.
I'll rest easy on the morrow, when the crown rests on one of my children's heads.
Feeling torn between Yalmar and Serys.
You mean, do I have a favorite?
I think Serys should have it.
They're as different as fire and water. But on Crate blood flows in both.
Between you and me, Hjalmar's not too hot-headed to be king.
Depends on the kind of king you have in mind. Want one who'll send emissaries, move figurines about a map, calculate the most profitable option? And yes, he's too hot-headed. But Skellige wants a different ruler. The kind who'll drown Nilfgaard in blood. Sooner jump into a fire than surrender. And that is Hjalmar.
If you escalate your attacks, you stand to infuriate Ymir. Could regret it someday.
In Skellige, we spit on the notion of peace at any cost.
Think the Council of Jarls will dare to put a woman on the throne?
If you'd asked me some months ago, I'd have laughed in your face.
And?
Today I see, and I'm not alone, that Serys has something as rare on the Isles as a hot summer. Patience. Others act, then think. She's different. She thinks things through, the for, the against. But once she takes action, not a force in the world could stop her.
Well, there you go then, she has everything Jamil has, but she has patience as well. Let's talk about my reward.
Promised me a reward for helping your children.
And I aim to keep my word. Here. This bauble's been in the family for generations. I give it to you for helping ensure the line endures.
Another sword?
Beautiful craftsmanship. Thanks.
I'm the one.
What's going on?
Started another row.
That's not Hjalmar. Let's go.
The hell? Fucking bear? Who let the bear in? So two of them. Three of them. Nicely done. Oh, who let these damn bears in? Plenty of meat to go around for the next banquet, though. She's still alive.
Cloth! Give me some cloth! Gotta stop the bleeding! Quick!
Da. Da.
Take my cloak.
It's more than a cloak.
Hold on, son. You'll pull through. A shark grabbed my leg once. Albion.
He's dead. Crack. Where'd those bears come from, huh? Answer. Now.
Careful how you speak to my da.
Stow your blade, pup, or Crack will lose a son, too.
You insult me, Lugoth, and now you threaten my son. I will not step to this.
Dan, come here. Come on. Put you down like a rabid dog.
Calm down. Calm down. Enough blood's been spilt. Someone brought these beasts here to murder our sons and brothers. We cannot restore their lives. But we can. We must avenge them. This burden falls upon the host and his offspring.
Find the guilty on Crete. Find and kill them. Else your clan will be cursed for 100 generations.
Oh, he feels better now, doesn't he?
Anybody see how the bears got in?
Don't matter. I know where to find the guilty already.
Wait! Are you mad? You're gonna kill folk before we've learned what happened.
Learn all you want. Meantime, I'll go wash the shame off our clan.
Hey, the Jarls aren't listening anymore. Stop playing the hero and think for a second.
Our honor's at stake, sis. That can't wait.
Are you listening to me? Someone let those bears in. We must know who, and the answer lies somewhere in this room.
You can have this farm without me.
You're right, Ceres. I'll help you.
Thanks.
Fine. See you when I return with the traitor's heads.
I'll stay here. Someone must see to everything. Summon the healer, hand the fallen over to their families. Wolf, I thank you.
Ever see anything like that?
No, and I hope I never will again.
Where'd the bears come from? We were all laughing, eating, drinking. Suddenly, a massacre. Torrents of blood on the walls.
What happened before the massacre? Be precise.
Young Lucas bet he could empty a barrel of beer in one go. He climbed on the table, grabbed a pony keg of Sintern wheat, and started chugging. His throat bulged like a blowfish. Face went red, but he kept drinking. Folks started banging their tankards on the table, shouted, "Lugos, Lugos." Then, from the other side of the room, we heard this roar. We turned in unison as if a coxswain had called. They were there. They were already there. Folks closest to the bears didn't even manage to draw their weapons.
Someone teleported them in.
They were ripped to shreds.
We'll avenge them, I promise.
This is sorceress. Or something.
Know who died?
Drogadar. Dragborn Dhu. Blue Boy Lugos. Yalborn. Otrig. Take some time, mention them all.
But you could name the claimants to the throne who survived in one breath. You, Hjalmar, and Svanriga.
What are you saying?
Nothing, just yet.
Someone was trying to kill them all off then.
We've talked enough. Let's look around.
Let me know what you find. I'll speak to the others. Maybe someone saw more than I did.
Examine the crime scene using your witcher sense.
Fang marks, claw marks, broken bones. Hard to say what exactly killed him.
A bear?
So many wounds. No wonder Hjalborn bled to death.
Looked away a moment. Turned back around. Saw a bear standing by the bench. What is the gods doing? Maybe they're punishing us.
For what?
Young Lugos. Bears took him by surprise. Didn't have a chance to defend himself.
You've no Otrig. Respect for our customs.
Shit, not no more than a kid.
You're that witch, Yennefer.
All right. What do we have here?
Salmon head.
Bear's head, but the tongue's short, like a human's.
Changelings.
Mouth smells of honey liqueur. Mead. And something else. Something...
The bear's transformed from humans to bear.
Before it's fermented. Strange.
Changelings.
Something under the fur. A tattoo. Shape of a bear paw.
Yep, it's a flipping shapeshifter.
Old scar. Looks like it was sutured. Half man, half bear. Something like a lycanthrope. No full moon, so something else caused the transformation. Maybe something he ate or drank. Mead. Mead with an earthy aroma. Need to check the horns, tankards, and bowls. Drogadar. Skald's played his last. All the horns are empty.
What about the barrels?
Bowl at each table. Mead in this one. And only mead.
What else?
Earthy scent from the bear's maw. Something towards mushrooms. Bowls empty. But the scent's in the air. Coming from... somewhere else in this room.
Where's the clouds? There you go.
Respect, Witcher.
Yes, respect me.
Here. Mead spiked with some kind of mushroom, and human blood.
Ceres, come here.
A guard saw what happened. Those weren't bears. They were...
men who transform into bears.
Uh-huh. Berserkers.
Berserkers?
Berserkers.
The Skald's name for warriors who change into animals in the midst of battle. The stuff of fairy tales. Legends. But it seems to make sense, right?
Mm-hmm. Almost. We were at a feast, not on a battlefield. Think I know what caused them to transform. The mead they drank. Smell this.
She's gonna turn to bear now.
Rawr.
Mead spiked with blood. And something else. Thinking it could be a mushroom, but I don't recognize the type.
Hjort might help us. Few druids know herbs better.
Can't hurt to try.
Okay, this is turning into a full-on quest. It's only going to be a quick thing. This is not too far away. Hey, was him, he did it.
Freyr, our mother. May the sea swallow the traitors. Freyr, our lady.
Mind if I interrupt?
Already have? What is it?
He did it.
Spiked one of the mead barrels with blood and something else. An herb or a mushroom. Sarah said,
give me the horn.
How did you know it's a horn?
I know the smell. A mushroom. Mardrom.
Mardrom related in any way to berserkers?
Aye. But only in the tales told to children as they are put to sleep on cold winter nights.
Yeah, that would help.
Warriors who ate Mardrom were said to transform into beasts when consumed by battle rage. But as I said, it's only...
only a legend, I know. Still, I find it easier to believe than some story about bears appearing out of nowhere. Saris wasn't lying. You know your fungi.
I do. Especially those which affect the mind, soothe it, summon waking dreams. Odalric suffered for years. I tried to help him in various ways, initially with prayer, then with poppy milk.
But he's done with that now, right?
It's not that simple. But we'll wean him off it yet.
Mardrom. Never heard of it.
You have another name for it on the continent. Psilocybe, I believe.
All right. Peasants eat it to soothe pain.
Udalric tried it too, but only a few times. In larger doses, the mushroom causes visions, nightmares.
Yes, the last thing Udalric needed more of. Thanks for your help. Blood and Mardrom. The taste of human flesh and a substance that triggers visions. That well could have caused the rage. Maybe even the transformation.
Maybe. Hard to believe someone spiked the mead here in the hall, though, in front of all those witnesses.
You're right. I helped prepare for the feast. I'd have noticed. It might have happened before they brought the drink upstairs. In the cellars, maybe? Come on, we could find some clues there.
See if we can find any other clues. Come on.
We must find the traitors quickly. Elsewise, the warriors will take matters into their own hands. Castle's a buzz already.
Think they'd attack Krak openly?
My father or each other. All in the finest Skellige tradition. Haven't had a good civil war in ages.
Foreigner,
brand those swords.
Knew there'd be trouble. It was all too calm.
Funny. Arnvold said the same. For a feast to be any good, mead's gotta flow. But so does blood.
Might say he got his wish. I really hope Hjalmar's doing something useful, not just looking for a fight.
Relax. Your brother's impetuous, not stupid.
How about that?
We keep the poison at the cellar's other end, down below. Come, I'll show you. The stench! Is that vodka?
Mahakaman spirit. Someone ruined
right
several
you.
Barrels of that finest. This mead's clean.
What about this one? Or this one? Or this one? Or this one over here?
Nothing here either. Blood and mushrooms. Think we can find out where this barrel came from? Looks different. What the? Shit.
The spirit! There's another exit behind the barrels, but they're too heavy. We'll never move them.
Don't intend to. Quick.
Who did that?
Desperate to bring our investigation to a quick end. There's a secret passage.
One rarely used, more like. When Hjalmar and I were little, we'd play here. Once. Ah, bygone days.
Come, sorry, step it up. Oh, yeah.
Medallion's humming. Place of power, it's gotta be.
Nice. Do you know what I'm going to spend it on? Igni. My new Igni upgrade. Sweet! Oh, put one in there now as well. Don't know if I've got to have a flipping. I don't think I have to have one in their door because there's only green, blue, and red mutagens. So I think general just automatically works, possibly. See if my health goes up. No, it's already at full anyway.
Get my hands on that pyromaniac.
Let's think. They had to use the entrance we used. Maybe they left some prints behind.
Maybe. When the door slammed shut and the fire broke out, did you hear a bottle shatter too?
No. But I have no witcher senses at my disposal. You must hear the hair growing on my head.
I try not to eavesdrop. Anyway.
Not the hair on your head.
Someone walked through the mead. Trail breaks off. Need to find another clue nearby, something else to follow. Must have felt his clothing rip. but was in a hurry.
What's this?
Piece of cloth.
No, it can't be.
What is it?
Arnvald's tunic. Only he wears this kind.
Sure about that?
Saw him in the main hall with the servants. Let's go.
Cool.
We'll chase him down. Come on.
Ironbolt! Stop, dammit!
Doubt he'll listen.
When I get my hands on him.
You don't stand a chance.
Way to see you, Borgdak!
Come on, Roach.
Fuck.
Shit, he's fast.
He wasn't that fast. Come on. Come on.
Got him!
Not so fast, Roach. Why do you betray them? Talk or I'll finish what I started.
No Ankrit should ever sit on Skellige's throne. I know you better than others do. You're hot-headed, irresponsible. Skelliger needs stability, a strong king. Not the kind a band of drunken jarls will choose.
Curious. Never heard you voice that idea. But I do know one who never stops saying it.
It's Birna Bran, isn't it? You were never a good liar, Arnvald.
What was her motive?
It's obvious. She schemed this up to get rid of the...
Calm down, horse.
Slander our clan in the process. If she succeeded... Svanrigger would have been left, the only claimant to Skellige's throne.
We need proof. Your word against Birna's, that's not
enough. What's doing?
Arnvald, help us, and I'll ask my dad to grant you an honorable death. I'll insist.
I have letters from her. Instructions. How to poison the mead. But she never signed them, there's no seal.
Will that be enough?
It'll have to be. We shouldn't delay. Time to gather the Jarls.
My job's done. Let me go.
I've assembled the Jarls in council as you demanded, Cerys Ankrit. You claim to know who's behind the slaughter at Caer Trolde. Speak then. The blood of Skellige's sons and daughters. Whose hands does it stain?
Birna Bran's. The lass is mad. Do you think anyone will believe you?
You had them serve poison mead to the berserkers.
I beg your pardon. The servants of Caer Trolde are not mine to command. 'Twas your father who called for the feast, who assembled the guests.
There's reason in these words.
Have you any proof to confirm your accusation?
I've better. I've a witness. Arnvald.
Cerys speaks true. Birna commanded me to poison the mead. When Cerys and the Witcher descended into the cellars.
You betrayed us. The clan that took you in.
Good man. He's a servant to Ankrit. a lackey. He will say what they command him to say. He would lie for them even were he to pay for it with his head.
Berner speaks true. Arnvald has served a Caer Troldr ever since I remember. Noily, look a dog.
I can vouch for Ceres. She's telling the truth.
You? Yet another uncrate lackey. Did Ceres entice you to cooperate? I can imagine how. Or has Crack paid you to smear my name?
What did you say?
Calm yourselves.
After what I saw on Speaker Rock, I trust the Witcher more than I do you.
You've that right. But it's no proof of my guilt.
Got one more piece of evidence.
A letter from Berna to Arnvald, instructing him how to spike the mead.
It lacks my signature. It lacks my seal.
But perfume soaked through the parchment. A very strong scent, you know. Still to be sensed.
Is this your proof, lass? Is this what you call evidence of my supposed treason? Don't make me laugh.
Berna's right, Ceres. Tis all precious little proof of her wrongdoing. Alas, your brother Hjalmar also has not presented anything that could clear your family's name. We've but one path left to us. Holger, Lugos, it's time we quit this damn castle. Come, we must decide what punishment Clan on Crate will face.
You're making a big mistake.
Silence, Wanderer.
Wait!
Mother, you bade me to leave the hall before the feast. Why?
Son, not now.
Why did you do it? How did you know? How?
You stand silent.
You gave Ceres no credence. Gave the Witcher no credence. But you must give credence to a son who accuses his own mother. The massacre was her doing. She shamed herself, me, the family, the clan.
Svanrike, I did it for you. Only for you.
You admit to this deed. As the eldest of the Jarls, I cleanse the name of Clan on Crate. And you, Berna Bran, I sentence to death.
Surely son wouldn't do that to his mother.
To perish of hunger and thirst. And sea fowl will peck apart your remains.
No, because she got what she deserved, but...
Berna had a lust for power, I knew this. But so strong as to commit such a crime.
What about Svanrige? What's his fate?
He'll lose his home, his name, his honor. He'll choose exile. Or death. But enough. Whatever comes, we must endure. I thank you, Geralt. Again.
And you're still not going to come to help me fight the Wild Hunt.
I'll not take any more of this modesty. This is a land of heroes. Let this remind you of that. And now, I must ride for Gedinnaeth, for the Jarl's Council. Time to pick a king.
What do you think? Who'll get the nod?
Come with me. See for yourself. All may listen to our deliberations.
I got them, why not?
I do have a horse in the race. Can't refuse, to be honest.
As I thought. Well, let's go.
Has a horse in the race? Who? Ceres, or what's his name? Jodvik.
Just in time.
They've already started.
Typical. I'm the Goddamn Witcher, she'd wait for me.
Weren't long ago, we gave King Bran back to the sea. Today, our mourning ends. Today, by the grace of the gods and the clans, a new ruler takes the crown.
Yeah.
Let us swear her fealty.
You want to give me a choice who to pick? I thought it might have done, but I'd have picked her anyway, probably.
Some would see another in my place. I thank those who stood at my side. Here, beneath the sacred oak, I pledge to be a good queen to the ones and the others. I want peace and prosperity to reign in Skellige. And I count on you to help me fulfill that dream.
Cerys! 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 Cerys!
He's not very happy, is he? Golf clap. Kingmaker. Surely we'd be able to approach the queen like that.
You'll make a great queen.
Thank you. Wouldn't be here if it weren't for you.
Got a delicate matter I wanted to bring up. Need your help.
What is it?
I've told you this already.
You must have.
Have you found her?
Not yet, but I'm close. Problem is, as soon as I get to her, the Wild Hunt will probably be able to locate us quickly. So I'll want to take her to Kaer Morhen. Battle the hunt there. I'm looking for allies.
I can't leave the Isles now.
What?
It's impossible.
You said you'd help me.
What I can do is give you my best warrior, Hjalmar.
Okay.
Think you'll be willing?
I'm sure of it. In fact, I think I'll be overjoyed. Come on, you know him.
Yeah, guess I do. Thanks.
No doubt he'll be valiant. I hope he proves useful too. Good luck.
You might have just signed his death warrant. What would you say?
You alright?
So-so. Anyway you cut it, I was bested by a wench.
Not just any wench.
Aye, true. Suppose if it had to be so...
Clean the blood off your face.
The Wild Hunt's preparing to attack Kaer Morhen. Could use your help.
Raids at the gate of your Witcher stronghold? You're a friend of the clan. I cannot refuse you. What's more, no one crates ever stood in battle such a foe. I'll leave at once.
Thanks. Yeah.
Won't forget this.
Quest complete then. Well done, Geralt.